Hi, I have a question for you and I want you to answer it really quickly. When you go to the gym and you are lifting your weights, are you building the muscle, right or wrong? Well, if you answer right, congratulations! You are an idiot. In all seriousness, I don't think you are an idiot. I love you and I don't blame you for not knowing this stuff. So, we're all good, right? Right? Please, Twitter, don't cancel me after this joke. Okay, now let's get back to the topic. What you are doing in the gym when you are actually lifting your weights, is not building muscle. Actually, you are doing the opposite. You are breaking your muscle fibers. So when you eat, you have the right nutrients, the right foods, it can grow bigger and stronger. Now that you know that, I'm going to show you the best foods for skinny people like me that we can have while trying to gain weight. Before I start this video, I just want to let you know that there are no foods that are going to serve as a magic pill during your muscle building process. You want to be aware and consistent about your calorie intake, since we want to be in a caloric surplus in order to build muscle optimally. If as of now you are not sure of what your calorie intake should look like, down below is going to be a link that is going to redirect you to a webpage that is going to calculate how much calories you need to gain weight, lose weight, or maintain weight. Here, we are looking for the calories in order to gain weight. Okay, now, the foods that we want must meet these two criteria, which are, first, that they are calorie dense. What that means is that they must have a low volume and a high calorie quantity for that volume. Secondly, these foods need to be relatively healthy, which means we don't want a lot of sugars and a lot of unhealthy fats in our diet, because we want to build muscle, not fat. Okay, I'm going to start with the carb sources. I have the list here on my phone in case I forgot it. So first we are going to talk about oatmeal. Oatmeal is amazing, really high amount of calories, a lot of carbs, really high quality carbs. It has some protein in there, which is really good, appreciated, and it's really affordable. Oatmeal is really affordable, you can get it super cheap and make delicious meals with it. Add your favorite toppings, preferably high calorie ones, and you can also add it into your shakes to increase the amount of calories your shake has. So oatmeal, fantastic. Okay, now we are going to talk about rice. Rice is amazing because it is really high carbs, really high calories, one of the cheapest things that you can buy ever, period. And it goes well with basically anything. If you are having some burritos, some chili, just throw some rice into it and you have increased the calories on the meal by a lot. Now we are going to talk about pasta. Pasta is honestly one of my favorite meals, since it is one of the most calorie dense foods that you can buy, and it's also really cheap, that's to say. One thing that I want to say is that pasta really easy and quick to make. Like, you only need like one brain cell in order to cook pasta. So easy, so quick, so delicious, so high calorie. I mean, you cannot go wrong with the pasta. Now, we already talked about oatmeal, but we haven't talked about oatmeal baked with honey, also known as granola. Granola is amazing. The calorie to volume ratio on this thing is absolutely crazy thanks to the honey. And yeah, it is really good if you can have it, let's say, on a fruit bowl, on your breakfast, on the go as a snack. It is really good, you should try it. It is amazing. Juan approved. Now, bread, I mean, how can you go wrong with bread? You just, have some slices and add your toppings into it, peanut butter, jelly, whatever you want, close it and boom, take it. A lot of carbs, a lot of calories, really good in order to bulk up. Not much to say. One of the best things about bread is that you can have it on the go as a snack. Really good, really good. Natural sunlight, as you can see, is running out, so I might just do this I know it maybe won't look the best, but I mean, it's what we have. Now I'm going to have two foods that are going to be in the same category because they are like pretty much the same, and those are tortillas and arepas. You know, if you are having your breakfast, let's say some eggs, some omelette, wrap it around a tortilla and boom, you have more calories, more carbs, and you won't even feel it that much. Same goes with arepas. If you are having your breakfast, normally, you know, add some arepas on the side or even put your breakfast on top of the arepa, and it is going to spike up the calorie intake. Really good, you cannot go wrong. Super cheap, pretty bueno. Next, sweet corn. Okay, I know that sweet corn is not that calorie dense, however, we are going to need some micronutrients in our diet, and why don't we get them from the highest calorie vegetables? And you know, sweet corn, really good, at least for me, I like the taste a lot, and it is considerably cheap, so why don't you give it a try? Now, for the same reason that we are having sweet corn, why don't we have some high calorie fruits as well? One of them being my personal favorites, bananas. Bananas are super high calorie, you know, they have a lot of micronutrients in there, most notably potassium, and they are considerably cheap and goes well into your shakes and your breakfast. So, really bueno, recommend. The last thing that we will have in our carb sources is going to be dark chocolate. Now, I know dark chocolate may have some sugar in it, but I mean, it is one of the healthy snacks that you can have. It has some caffeine in there, so be conscious of not consuming it too late at night. But with that said, you know, pretty high calories, lots of carbs, you know, some sugar in it, but not that much really. Really good if you take it as a pre-workout or just generally as a snack throughout the day. Now, moving on with our fat sources, we'll start off with cheese. Okay, cheese. I love the taste of cheese. I am such a big fan, and it is really cheap, really good, goes well with everything. However, I cannot have it, since if I have diarrhea, I am going to start breaking out even more than I already break out. So, you know, not bueno for my skin. And looking for non-dairy cheese here in Colombia, it's really expensive, so you know, it isn't worth the try, and it doesn't have that many calories as the normal cheese has, so you know, not really worth it. But if you can have dairy and if you don't break out, congratulations, I would highly advise to you that you have cheese in your diet. Next, peanut butter, a fat source that I can consume, and let me tell you, this thing is amazing. Remember that fat sources are normally going to have more calories than carb sources and protein sources, since a 1 gram of carbs or protein equals to 4 calories, while 1 gram of fats equals to 9 calories. So, you know, naturally they will have more calories. However, we want to regulate the amount of fats that we are consuming, not too much, but a healthy amount. And speaking of healthy, peanuts are mad healthy. They have good micronutrients in there, monosaturated fats, which are really good. A lot of calories. Oof, man, this thing has a lot. Quite cheap. It goes well with any sweet meal that you are having as a snack, with, let's say, some bread and peanut butter. That's good. Or you can have it on your shakes to increase by a ridiculous, absurd amount the calories that you are consuming. Peanut butter, amazing. Next, avocados. Avocados are like right in the middle of cheap and expensive. You have avocados, they're not super cheap, but also not super expensive, but high calories, high fats, high micronutrients, amazing food. I enjoy it a lot. For example, having some arepas and throwing in there like half an avocado, squishing it in there, some salt, and it goes in there with maybe some eggs. It is delicious, it is pretty good if you like the taste of avocado, because I know a lot of people don't, but if you enjoy it, I will highly recommend it to you. Next, hummus. Hummus is a really nice food. It has a lot of calories, a lot of good fats, some micronutrients is there, thanks to the chickpeas that the hummus is made of. So yeah, really good food. It can be a really good replacement for the avocados. If you don't like avocados, or even if you do like them as me, you can find it as a replacement. For example, when we don't have any avocados here at home, what I will do is have hummus instead, you know, spread them on my tortillas or on my arepas and have the same breakfast as I have, but with the hummus, same calories, really good. You might enjoy it. Now, again, two foods that are going into the same category because they are pretty much the same, and those are coconut oil and olive oil. Now, I personally prefer olive oil since it is the cheapest, and you know, coconut oil can get like really expensive, but you know, olive oil is a really good option, really good fats, really amazing amount of calories in there. You should basically cook everything that you do with olive oil. There's like a zero reason to ever use another oil if you are bulking. So yeah, olive oil, stick with it, cook with it, and do amazing things with it. Just like don't do this crazy bodybuilding stuff where they take like yogurt with olive oil or just the pure olive oil. Don't do that, please. We are civilized people. Next, we have nuts. Nuts can normally get expensive. However, if you are like me and you enjoy looking for the best deals and all of that, you can find nuts for a really good price. And I mean, it is worth it because lots of calories, lots of fats. A handful, like having this in my hand, has like probably 200-300 calories, and you just chop it in your mouth. That's your snack, a pretty high calorie, really recommended. So yeah, the only thing is that you will need to find good deals in your area in order to get them, because they can get a little bit expensive if you are not cautious. And for the end of our fat sources section, we will have pumpkin seeds. Pumpkin seeds are surprisingly quite cheap, I'm going to say, and you know, good fats, high calories, has some protein in there, which is well appreciated, and you can add it, let's say, on toast salads, with your rice. If you are having like a bowl of fruit, you can sprinkle some, you won't even notice they are there. So yeah, really good. I will really advise you to include them in some way into your diet. And finally, starting our protein sources, we have eggs, my favorite protein source. I love eggs because they are cheap and taste amazing and have really high quality protein, like the best quality protein in the market. Each egg has around like 6 grams of protein and 70 calories, which might not sound like a lot, but considering that you will be having like 3-4 eggs, it is quite a considerable amount of calories and protein, you know. And like I say, the best protein that you can have on the market, it is the most bioavailable protein, which means it has the most chance that that protein that you are consuming is going to be converted, transformed into muscle. So eggs, really good, have a lot of them. Yeah. Next, we have salmon. Salmon, it can get quite expensive, I'm not going to lie to you. That's why I don't have it as much. I only have it like once every 2 weeks, once every month. However, when you have the opportunity, go buy it, since it is amazing. It has a lot of protein, high quality protein, a lot of fat, and a lot of calories. It is like the best meat that you can find, but unfortunately, quite expensive, so I won't get it as much. I don't think anyone wants to buy expensive stuff that often, but when you have the opportunity, definitely go buy it. Next, we have protein powder, and actually Hold up real quick. Okay, now I'm going to show you the protein that I'm consuming right now. They don't sponsor me on any means, but they should. Okay, so this protein is called Titan Beef Mass. Yeah, you guessed it, is beef protein. Since I already explained, I cannot have any dairy, therefore no whey, no casein. However, look what this bad boy has to offer. I'm going to read the nutritional label. The nutritional label here is measured on 6 scoops. That is too much for me. I only have 2, so we are going to just divide it on 3. You know, math, basic math. So the serving size won't be of 180 grams. It is going to be of 60 grams. So for 60 grams, you are going to get 250 calories. Yeah, you heard that right. 20 grams of protein and 40 grams of carbs. Are you insane? Are you crazy, bro? So that's to show you that you don't have to fear mass gainers, quite the opposite. I encourage you to have mass gainers into your daily lifestyle, because the bad boy right here has everything you need. High calories, high protein, high carbs. Amazing. There are actually a few things that you need to be aware of. First, you want to look in the nutritional label that it has a low content of sugar, because what most companies do is that to increase the calorie content of their products, what they do is, you know, just throw some sugar in there and that's it. That's not what we want. So, you know, look for low sugar products. This product actually has zero sugar, so that's pretty bueno. Secondly, you want to look at the price. Mass gainers can seem a little bit pricey at first. However, you need to do some math in order to know the real price that you're paying for your protein. First, you want to divide the size of the bag by the size of each serving. So for example, the size of the bag, I don't know if you can see it right there, is 2270 grams, and now for the serving size is actually 60 grams. So if we divide that, we get 38 approximately. Now you divide the cost of the full bag by the number that you just got. So for example, in my case, this bag cost like 30 bucks. So I divide 30 by 38 and that gets me 0.70. That number that you just got is the price per serving of your protein. So in my case, I'm just paying 70 cents for each serving of my protein, which is amazingly cheap. So yeah, we can conclude that you can have mass gainers. They are full with carbs, protein, calories, and they are cheap in the long term. And finally, we're going to wrap it up with 2 foods that go into the same category, because they are like pretty much the same, and those are chicken breast and pork tenderloin. It's starting to rain. Oh no, that's bad. That is not bueno. So, pork tenderloin and chicken breast. High in protein, super high in protein actually, and good quality protein. They are like so bioavailable. They are considerably cheap, and if you cook them properly, you can make them delicious. So yeah, there you have it. Now you have like over 20 foods in order to gain weight as a skinny kid. Now you have like zero excuses. That's bueno, and I hope that this video helped. If it did, don't forget to drop a like and subscribe to this channel. Next video is going to be really epic. It's something that I will be really excited to share with you. So yeah, that's everything for today. See you next time. Ciao, bye, adios, tengo sueño, me voy a dormir.